Today, folks, I'm breaking down how much dividend income I made for the year of 2020. And this is part two of a series of videos I'm putting together, kind of giving you guys the most transparency around my income sources as possible, with the last video being how much money I made off this YouTube channel. So many of you are aware, I show it every week, my entire accounts, my income, which for the year of 2020 was $6,443 off my dividend stocks. But I figured I could offer a little bit more education, a little more insight by diving down into the individual stocks just to see who paid me what and how much. And then I'm going to show you the projected income I'm likely to make going through next year. So in the clarity of my transparency, as always, folks, do the channel a favor, hit that like button, and let's jump right into this. Investors, now diving down right into my little iCloud spreadsheet here that documents everything that I make, guys. We're going to kick this off by talking about Apple, first of all, being the highest rated for dividend security, which paid me out nothing major here. I'm by no means a Warren Buffett of the world. I do not hold tens of thousands of dollars of Apple here, so my payments aren't exactly just stellar. But taking a look in February, I got 26 bucks. Clearly, Apple increased their dividend going into May, where I got 27 bucks. And then kind of sliding into August, we can see over the quarter, I took some profits there. We slipped down to $21, at which I took even more profits over the next quarter, and we're only making $17 now moving forward off my Apple position. Over the entire year, I only made $91 off Apple. I cannot live off of that, which leads us into the next tech giant here, of course, being Microsoft, one that I haven't touched, haven't sold any of it, never scaled it down. And we can see that in March, I got 26 bucks. In June, I got 26 bucks. In September, I got 26. And then, oh yeah, Microsoft increased their dividend, so I am now getting $29, which equals to a total amount of $107. So between Apple and Microsoft, I made $198. Again, nothing relatively life-changing for the scale of the positions, because it's nice seeing those kind of capital gains, but I can't live off them unless I sell them. So let's move into some of the higher paying dividend stocks. One of the most controversial of my holdings being GEO Group, which is the most staggered income producer I've had in my entire portfolio, because in February I got $163, at which I got another payment not even 2 months later. So this wasn't paying out in quarterly payments. They were very unusual, because going into April I got $196, a little bit more than February's. And then going into July, keep in mind this is post withholding tax. After withholding tax, they usually take about 20 bucks, right? But nonetheless, in July, I got $178. And then in October, I got $126, bringing the total income off my GEO Group of $663. A love-hate relationship with GEO Group. Prison rate, highly controversial. Got me on Netflix, a Netflix special called Immigration Nation. I don't need to go up myself too hard on that one. It's the only reason I'm still holding it, is because I got kickbacks in other ways. But moving on to some better companies that still have really controversial stories around them, we got to talk about the healthcare sector with J&J, my Johnson & Johnsons of the world, which also has paid out in a very staggered manner for the year, because I got my first dividend of $58 in March, and then I didn't get a dividend payout for at least until July there, so right into the midst of summer, where I got $62, and then for some reason, 2 months later, I got another dividend in September of $86, and then my final dividend payment just came in of $86. Now, this came from me scaling Tesla down and scaling Johnson & Johnson up, with a total income for the year of about $291. Really not that bad. I kind of like my J&J. It'll be one that'll ride or die me into the grave, right? Now let's talk about the sin, the smoke stocks, my horrible addictions I vaped through the year. By the way, I quit vaping now and smoking nicotine in general. MO paid me out January, 204 bucks, which was a very large payment. I can't remember if I scaled it down or not, because for some reason going into April, my dividend was $110, which it was in July, and October was a little higher, and I have no idea why, unless it's related to like dollar conversions or something, giving me a total for the year of 553 USDs, baby, which is absolutely wonderful. So let's compare it to my BTI income. British American Tobacco for February, I got $84, at which we've seen a bit of an increase into May, which I don't know if I bought more or not this year. I don't think I did, but either way, $111, which we saw another increase into August of $119. and then another increase into November of 138, bringing me a total of 452. And the only reason I can believe these numbers are like segregated and not even at all is for two reasons. Probably maybe because I bought a little bit more somewhere this year, and then on top of that, maybe because of some fluctuations in the currency, because British American Tobacco is a British company. So putting the sin sector aside, let's talk about my utility Southern Company, which has been paying me fairly evenly all the way around. Now, I remember when I scaled the Apple down, I did buy more Southern Company. So we're going to see that inflection in here when we're talking about $54 in March, $55 in June, September $66, and then December $66. I was very happy when I bought it because when I started scaling into the position this year, it was only because Apple was soaring through the roof. And this one was actually down pretty substantially when I picked it up. So my total income of $241 for this sucker, leaving me into my final US position here before we talk about my Canadian stocks with Wells Fargo that I actually sold. I kind of converted it over to Pepsi, and just taking a look, I got $5 when I was holding Wells Fargo. I sold it. I don't know when I sold it, but I got $11 again in June. And then finally, when I converted over to my Pepsi stock, about $52 for the month of September. So that total position between Wells Fargo and Pepsi for the year, only $68. For the year end of 2020, my US dividend income sits around, I think, $2,400 to $2,500. There's still some discrepancies because some of this doesn't exclude the withholding tax, which you're gonna have to minus out 15% on some of it, not all of it. And then, of course, there's still some income tax on some of the stocks that aren't in a tax-advantaged account. But let's put all that aside, guys. We're not gonna talk about capital gains, purely dividends in this one. So let's move to the Canadian side of the border with my other utility we should talk about being Northland Power, one of my favorite dividend stocks, arguably my favorite dividend stock of all time, paying me out an even $50 every month for the entire year, making me a total of $605 Canadian. No complaints. Taking a look at my bank in Nova Scotia, I slightly added to this position this year. And again, these stocks, my Canadian stocks, have been paying way more congruently, way more evenly than my US stocks. So it's nice because it helps me project out my future. But taking a look, BNS started the year at $121. And then by the end of the year, because I scaled it up a bit, and I also think I used some of my Apple money that I sold out of Apple to scale this as well, sitting at $176 for that last dividend payment with a total income of $543 for the year. Beautiful, beautiful stuff. And similar deal with Canadian Imperial Bank. Started the year getting $128, where we skipped to today, I'm getting $152 on that last quarterly payment with a total annual income for 2020 of $541. And then finally, we got to talk about the most controversial stock, which, by the way, in here, I haven't added TD yet. TD, I'm not sure, has paid me a dividend yet. If it did, it didn't equate to much because I've only just recently been scaling it. So that's why it's not on the list. But keep in mind, I do own TD, which will be something that'll come up next year. But my second most controversial position next to GEO Group, we got to talk about RioCan, which I need to get as a license plate for my vehicle because of the amount I've talked about it this year. And after the dividend cut, guys, at least for the rest of the year, we're still collecting large payments. First, RioCan distribution dividend there for January of this year was $27. Leading into the end of the year, this is how much I scaled it up. I made $186, guys, my last payment. Now, going into January is when we're going to see our final big juicy payment, because then we're going to see a 30% dividend cut, taking that dividend income down to about $130 to $140 range, which is going to really hurt me inside. But I'm happy to still be receiving well over $100. Most of this is not in a tax-advantaged account. But in total, the income off this was $1,344, roughly, for the year of 2020. So guys, you kind of add all of that up, and that brings me to the total conclusion of $6,443 of dividend income, all converted to Canadian dollars, by the way, for the year of 2020. But what does the year of 2021 look like? Well, it's gonna be kind of hard to gauge out because I won't know until the dividend cuts kind of come into play here. But let's just take a speculative look by diving down into my basic brokerage accounts. Let's start with my TFSA here, guys. This is where I hold most of my tax-free income, where you can see how much money I'm receiving on the Canadian side of the border, US side, all projected out, by the way. None of it's 100% accurate. But discluding the RioCan dividend cut, which hasn't been calculated in yet, we can see that Scotiabank is projecting that I will be making around $2,527 in Canadian dollars for 2021 and about $2,216 on the US side of my income. Taking a look at my managed account, this is where I was using all my dividend income from RioCan to pay my line of credit, which thank God I paid that off this year because, again, dividend cut. And just taking a look, guys, I'm making even $85 a month off this sucker right now. For the annual income of 2021, should be around $1,025, but again, cut that by 30%. You're probably looking at closer to around $700 in income, so kind of annoying, but still not complaining. Love my Ryokan, right? And then finally, we'll take a quick look at my RR to the S to the P, where I keep scaling up Kimberly Clark. Many of you know I've been adding these new positions here, guys, which again, I haven't really kind of calculated any of that dividend income fully yet, but nonetheless, just taking a look, for 2021, I'm projected to make 827 USDs off of this account particularly. And then I also have my Royal Bank account, but I haven't really projected this out correctly because I got TD in here, BNS, Ryokan. I think I projected out that it's gonna make me another 800 to 1,000 bucks going into next year. So let's step back, take a breath, guys. What have we learned this year over all my dividend income? Well, you can't trust any high-flying dividend stocks when you're talking about things like Geo Group or Ryokan, because clearly we saw dividend cuts and that dividend income hasn't been as reliable as we could have hoped. But where we saw the most dividend reliability has been in anything related to utilities, anything related to the financial sector and the healthcare sector, guys. I'm showing you guys the full breakdown. It kind of gives you a perspective on the different sectors of the market, because even though you could say Apple, Microsoft, great dividend stocks, I mean, I only made $197. That doesn't equate to anything that I could live off of without taking profit. So it made sense for me to scale those down and kind of beef up my favorite dividend pairs, which are proving to be fairly fruitful right now. So in light of all of this, I pass the question off to you. I'd love to know what you guys think in that comment section below, but stay cool, stay awesome, and I look forward to catching you tomorrow.